Theresa here of Lark and Design, and so welcome to my process video for a traditional layout called You Are Beautiful. And so what I wanted to do was share a layout or create a layout that just reminded me that I am beautiful. A couple of weeks ago I bought a new shirt from Target, and it was really pretty, and it was just, sometimes you just buy some clothes that make you feel really pretty and make you feel good about yourself. And so that happened, and I wanted to create a layout about that, but I wanted to remind myself. And the traditional layouts that I'm going to be creating over the next few weeks are going to be mixed media layouts that I want to create in order to remind myself of things that I need to hear that week. And so what I've done here is actually printed my title onto the patterned paper. I printed the title onto plain white cardstock first, and you saw me pull this pattern paper off of the cardstock after I printed it. My Canon Pixma does not allow me to print on 12 by 12 paper by itself, so I attached the 12 by 12 to a 13 by 19 sheet using washi tape. And so this is the pattern paper now with the title printed on it, and I have taped off the title, and now I'm using a stencil. This is a stencil from Jane Davenport from her brand new mixed media collection, and it's the floral stencil. I don't think it has a name other than it comes in a pack with a washi folder that you can use in your traveler's notebook or in your Jane Davenport notebooks. And so this is the floral stencil that I'm using here. And my concept for this is to stencil the floral pattern around the title, and then I want to watercolor around the floral. And granted, I don't know how this is going to work out, or if what I've conceptualized, if it's going to look right or look good when it's done. I don't know any of that. This is part of the mixed media and the art journaling process that I enjoy doing and that I want to include in these layouts. And so right now I'm just in the process of laying down the stencil and using modeling paste to create the floral pattern. I am taping off the stencil at certain places to keep it from going over into the text. I don't want the modeling paste to touch the text. So one of the things that I want to achieve with these layouts, it's kind of personal, actually. I guess it could be sort of called a selfie project or something like that. But sometimes I know that I don't hear the things that I always need to hear. And I'm pretty sure that there are others who can relate to that. For one thing, it's easier to hear. For some reason, it's easier to hear, and it's easier to remember the negative things that you hear about yourself or that you believe about yourself. And I'm trying to change that about myself. And trying to help myself realize the truth that it isn't always negative, right? And hopefully you'll be able to relate to this as well as I go through this process of sharing these layouts with you. I hope that you'll be inspired too. And I hope that you'll hear this message too. And when you see these words across this page, I hope that you'll see that and believe that about yourself too. So I think what I'm doing is I've chosen two of the floral icons to use. I think there are four florals on these stencils, and I've chosen to repeat two across the page. And so I'm just alternating, and I'm sort of cleaning them as I go and then laying them back down. You can absolutely lay down your stencil over top of modeling paste that has already dried or already set. Just be careful when you do that. It will smudge the new modeling paste a little bit, and that's okay. I'm taking that. You can see a little bit of smudge in the second floral that I did, and I'm taking that as part of the imperfectly perfect beauty of creating your own, right? And this is part of the mixed media experience as well. I mentioned at the beginning of this video that I don't really know what the outcome will be. And this has been really freeing for me. If you followed me last year, and you can also look back in my archives, I think there's a playlist that includes my art journaling layouts that I did last year. And one of the reasons why I chose to do some art journaling layouts and why I want to continue doing some mixed media work this year is because it did free me from being invested in the outcome. And what I mean by that is, so many times we sit down to do creative work and we have an idea in our mind of what we think it should look like. And sometimes we're able to achieve what we think it should look like. And sometimes we're not able to achieve what we had set in our mind. And sometimes that becomes a roadblock to creativity. Because sometimes we might say, well, I have in my mind what I want to do, and I know I can't make it look like that, so I'm just not going to do it at all, right? And how many times have you looked at someone like, oh, I don't know, who's a good mixed media artist? She designs for Prima, Marimi, Small Art, Small Media Designs, or something like that. Beautiful layouts, beautiful work, an amazing person. Just love watching her videos, love following her work. But I look at her layouts sometimes and I think, I could never do something that looked like that, and so I'm just not going to try. And what I want us to hear in that is that that's actually stopping us from being involved in the creative process, simply because it won't turn out the way we think it should look. And in reality, when we sit down to create, what we create is going to look like we do it. It's not going to look like what somebody else does it. And I've talked about this before, I know. If you sat down with this pattern paper and these stencils and the same modeling paste, your layout is going to look different from mine, even if you copy mine, because it's going to look like you, and it's going to be an expression of you. And so the thing that I love about mixed media and working through this process is this idea of, I don't know what the outcome is going to be, and I'm going to go for it, and I'm going to work with whatever comes of it. And I have to say that my art journaling and mixed media work began and is heavily influenced by Donna Downey. A couple of years ago, I started watching her Inspiration Wednesdays, and I love watching her work and love seeing what she does in her art journals. And she's classic for one, gesso. She uses gesso like it's going out of style. But two, she'll say in the middle of the video, she'll say, I'm not really sure I like how that turned out, so I'm going to step away from it for a little while and I'll be back and I'll fix it or I'll work with it. And then she'll come back and she'll work with it and she'll keep working with it and adding layer after layer until she gets it to look like she likes. And so when I sit down to do my mixed media and art journaling, I'm heavily influenced by her work, and I sort of use that too as my guide. Sit down and work with it for a while. If you're not liking how it's turning out, step away from it and then come back to it and work with it some more and keep going with it, because this is part of the creative process. And and committing, you have to commit to what you're putting on the paper, even if it doesn't look exactly like you imagined or thought or expected, to be okay with that. And so hopefully you'll be able to take inspiration from that as well. What I've loved about that process and from doing that on a regular basis, what I've loved about that is that it has made me a little more brave and a little more okay with what I'm producing. Like, I'm okay with what I'm creating because it's a reflection of me, not a reflection of someone else. And that has helped me enjoy my creative process more. I'm enjoying the process of creating these scrapbook layouts. Do they look like a layout that Irit Langgraf is making? No, probably not. Do they look like a layout that Mercy Tiara is making? No, they don't, because they're me. They're what I do, and they might seem strange, right? The things that I make might seem strange, and it might feel uncomfortable. It's going to feel uncomfortable because it's not familiar. And that not familiar place is hard to be, isn't it? When you don't know how it's going to be received, and especially when you share online, and you don't know what people are going to think, and that's okay. Share it anyway, create it anyway. Put yourself in that uncomfortable place of creating what you create, because that's who you are, and that's what you do, and that's what you're going to love. I'm convinced that we create layouts that we love when we use products we love, and photos we love, and are telling stories that we love. So these are my two photos that I am working with on this layout, and I wanted to place them really quickly before I start in on the watercolor portion, and just so that I have an idea in my head of where they're going, and I know that I don't have to do heavy watercolor underneath that, and I don't want to do watercolor on the whole page. I do want some of the wood texture to show through underneath the flowers. And so what I'm doing here is, this is one of the Jane Davenport watercolor palettes. I think it's called, it's the Brights. And, I just have to tell you, they're gorgeous. Oh my goodness. They really are pretty colors. And so I wanted to go ahead and paint the swatches so that I knew what they were. I have to admit, I've never gotten a watercolor palette where I had to unwrap all the individual little pieces. It was almost like unwrapping bullion cubes. But they're really pretty, and it's a really beautiful palette. And so now I'm going to give a disclaimer here, where this portion of the process video is not for the faint of heart. Because this is where I take a flying leap of faith that I don't know how this is going to come out. I don't know how this is going to work out. But I'm just going to go for it. So what I wanted to do was have the color around the flowers. Not inside the flowers, but around the flowers. And some of that is achieved very loosely. I'm going to outline the modeling paste that is set on the page, and then run the water over to spread that water, to spread the paint across the page. And I'm gonna experiment a little bit on how to make that work. Now, one thing that I realized after the fact is that the watercolors actually didn't spread as well as they could have, because they aren't on gesso, they're on the pattern paper. I thought about using some gesso around these flowers, but I decided not to, because I wanted to just go with the flow of the process, and I wanted to still keep this wood grain and not cover it up with gesso. And gesso does not cover completely, but it does make it opaque, if that makes sense. So that's okay. What I'm learning here is how to manipulate this watercolor on pattern paper that has not been treated with gesso. And so it's kind of fun, of course, and it's kind of challenging. And most importantly, I just want to enjoy the process and let it take shape, whatever that looks like. I'm using, I think, 3 or 4 different colors, maybe 5 different colors here. I did want to introduce color on this layout. Now, when it was wood grain and just white flowers and black text on the pattern paper, it was a neutral. They were very neutral colors and a very neutral background. But these colors add, they add depth and dimension to the page, and a lot of visual interest. Hopefully you'll see that at the very end. But this is definitely not for the faint of heart, and I think I probably died a few deaths while I was doing this, I'll be honest, because I didn't know. I didn't know if I was gonna like it until it was done. And that's okay too. So I made a few executive decisions about where to put the watercolors, and I included a few just tiny places around the text just to draw your eye into the text. I wanted that to be a focal point of the layout, because that's the message that I want the receiver to get, that you are beautiful. I was inspired by, there's a stamp set that Kelly Stamps has released, and I think Kelly Perky has released a stamp set too with an outline alphabet, and I've been seeing a lot of layouts using those outline alphabets in a large font, and they're really pretty. And so that has inspired me to create my own title here just on the computer. I think the font I used is called Modern Number 20. It is available, I use Photoshop through the Creative Cloud, so it's available in their type kit, I think it's called. So there we go. There is the watercolor portion, and I'm going to heat set it, and I'm also going to let it sit overnight. What happens at this point, because the watercolors are really wet, and so what happens at this point is that the paper begins to curl up a bit, right? And I'm okay with that. I'm good with that. What I will end up doing after I finish heat setting it, I didn't realize I kept all this in the video, but that's okay. I also painted my desk underneath the the layout. The watercolors sort of bled through the paper a little bit, so now my white worktop is brightly colored by Jane Davenport, but that's okay. So this is now the next day, and what I'm doing is I'm taking a piece of plain cardstock, so it's like craft paper cardstock, and I'm putting a lot of adhesive on it. And you can see how my paper is bent, right? It's curled a little bit from taking on the watercolor. And so I sprayed the back of it, and I put the adhesive down on the new cardstock. And then I'm going to tape them together, adhere them together. And when that adhesive dries with the slightly damp paper, it will take on some of that, the nature of the new cardstock, and straighten a little bit. It'll also be a little more sturdy now that the water broke down some of the fibers in the pattern paper. It needs a backing on it that's a little more able to hold up. So, the next step is to add my photos and embellishments and journaling to the layout. And so I am using the Crate Paper Oasis collection. And interestingly enough, this is not a tropical layout. It's not a tropical blouse. I'm not visiting the tropics, but that wood paper called to me. I wanted to use that. And there are some ephemera and some embellishments in the Oasis collection that aren't necessarily tropical. But then I ended up using the palm frond embellishments anyway. But what I really wanted to use was one of these gold words. I love these gold puffy words. They're amazing. And of course, one of them says beautiful. But I'm not going to use that just yet. I'm going to arrange my ephemera and sort of figure out how I'm going to lay all these out onto the layout first. Also, this is the vellum sheet. It's a gold foiled sheet of tags, and oh my goodness, they're gorgeous. So I ended up just cutting out one of those. It says fun, and it has the mint green color on it, and I'm using the mint green tag next to it as well. So I'm going to just trim it up a little bit. So those are the supporting pieces to the photos, and then the ephemera comes next. And I just chose a couple of pieces of ephemera. There's a label and the camera, of course, and a little pink strip that says the ray. That was cute. And I basically just move these around the photos, and sort of, I want your eye to be drawn into the photos themselves, so the ephemera becomes supporting pieces. A little bit of gold, of course, and these palm fronds. I love them. So I basically kind of loosely arrange things around the page, and then I pull them all up and adhere them. So they don't always go back exactly the way that I had planned to, and that's okay too. I think in some ways that adds a little of the whimsy to the positioning of your ephemera, right? They don't go quite back the way that you expected. That's okay too. I really wish that they had put more of these palm fronds in there. I'm going to have to go look for a cut file now. So I'll have more to use later on. But I'm definitely glad I used them here. So I stepped away for a second to grab some pop dots. I'm going to raise up the second photo, or it's actually the primary photo. I took a photo of my outfit, the one that's already adhered down, and shared that one on Instagram. Loved it, loved it, loved it. And then I also took this other one of my face. And so I decided to include both of those here. And I love repeating the word beautiful. It'll make sense when I add the journaling to this. But I love repeating the word beautiful across the page. So right now it's in the outline font. It's in the gold puffy sticker. And now it's getting ready to also be written by hand. And so my journaling says, I know that people have tried to tell you differently, and that makes it difficult to hear the truth. That's part one, and then part two I'm going to write below here. So here are a few reminders. Yes, you are beautiful. And so basically my thoughts are that sometimes I don't hear that I am beautiful. You know, when my husband tells me, you look beautiful today, or you're a beautiful lady, or you have a beautiful body, and sometimes I don't, it's hard to hear that because we've heard so many negative things about ourselves. So I hope that you're hearing that you're beautiful today. And maybe if you're inspired to create a layout like this, then I hope you'll share it. Tag me so that I can see what you've done too. I would love to see it. I am going to add a little bit of stamping around the page. I added the date, and then I'm using this pink paisley Take Me Away roller stamp just to add a few sentiments. I think I stamped all the colors and Take Me Away, something like that. I'm not sure. Alright, so this layout is completed. I'm just going to straighten up a little bit and I'll share with you the overall layout. Thanks so much for watching. I do hope that you will like and comment and subscribe. And check back again soon. I will share another similar layout. Hopefully every week from here on out for a while, and see how this project goes. So let me know in the comments below if you're enjoying this series, if you like it, and if it's helpful to you. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.